Hello world, I'm an average Joe and I play games, and welcome to Destiny Deconstructed, where I break down the technical aspects of the game. And today we are going to cover orbs and orb generation. I got a couple of questions from you guys, the subscribers, about orbs and how they work, so we're going to go over that quickly today. Gameplay in the background is just me grinding a little bit on Exclusion Zone because there's a lot of majors when you play on Exclusion Zone, and it demonstrates a little bit of what I'm going to cover. So everyone knows that orbs are generated when you kill enemies, when you have your super ability active, and when you pick up an orb from another guardian in your fire team, then it recharges your super. It takes between 6 and 12 orbs to recharge your super, and it depends on a couple of factors on how those orbs are generated. A player with higher intellect, their orbs are going to have more energy in them, and they will replenish their fire teammates' super faster than someone with low intellect. So make sure that your guardians aren't dumb, if you know what I'm saying. Additionally, if you got your super naturally by letting it recharge, your super, the orbs generated from that super are going to be more charged than someone who picked up orbs and then used their super, so that it discourages being able to chain supers together, one after the other. As far as the number of orbs that you can create, it seems to me that orb generation is maxed at around 8 or so, at least for both my Voidwalker and Sunsinger that I tested this on. That's what it was. And so the quickest way to generate orbs is to kill majors or ultras. Those are the yellow bar enemies. You kill one of those with your super active and you will generate 4 orbs of light. So if you can just kill 2 supers, you will reach your maximum orb generation while your super is active. And the best way to chain supers together is to have multiple warlocks, because particularly with the Voidwalker, you can have the Obsidian Mind, and as long as you can kill 2 ultras, which is really easy to do in like a Nightfall, if you get 2 ultras in your blast of your Nova Bomb, you'll generate 8 orbs, and you will restore a significant portion of your super because of the Obsidian Mind. And then if you have a second warlock in your fire team, it can get really redonkulous really quickly, because they're going to pick up 8 orbs, and if they had an Obsidian Mind when they did their Nova Bomb, they are going to have a full super ability, and then they're going to be able to Nova Bomb and generate 8 orbs for you, and then you can Nova Bomb again and create 8 orbs for them, and you can literally, 2 warlocks, Voidwalkers can, if they're spec'd correctly, can literally carry an entire fire team through a Nightfall, and it is really fun, let me tell you what. Well, there you go. There you guys have it. That is the lowdown on orbs and orb generation. Thank you very much for watching. Leave a comment down in the comment section below if I missed anything. Hit that subscribe button, follow me on Twitter, do all that good stuff that you guys do to show your support. We'll see you in the next game.